So when you first open the Avare app, it's going to open up to the sectional and where you are. And that's after you have everything configured, which we'll go into after. But just to show you, it also has plates of the airports. This is Plymouth, so that you can kind of see a diagram of the thing. You have an airport facilities directory, okay, which shows you unicoms, frequencies, weather report information. If you have Google Hangouts, you can actually call the real one. It's pretty cool. You can actually hear the weather report over the phone. Not that you need that, but again, this is designed for real-world aviation, but with the help of a plugin, can be used for Flight Simulator X or Flight Simulator 2004. So it has all the runways at Plymouth, which is what I set for my destination. It has everything you need. Everything you need for world aviation, but it's awesome for flight simming too. You can find airports, you just type in the identifier there and it'll search for it. These are all the airports that I searched for. Okay. And then this is planning. Now listen, this will actually, if you set it up, it'll actually send a flight plan, like for real life flight plans. So you don't want to submit them into a real world flight plan, obviously, but you can plan out your flight still. For example, this was a flight from a long time ago. Oops. You can create a new plan, enter in all your waypoints. You can do your briefings. I don't use this so much when I'm flight simming. Still not into the cross country yet in my private pilot training. But and not only that, but I'm going to do it the old fashioned way with just paper and pen. And pencil, because I want to be able to race. But I'll be doing that, and then hopefully showing a video once I'm on the cross country with that stuff. I know a little bit about it, but I'm not going to make a video until I've actually gone over with my flight instructor. But the big thing about this for flight simming is you can actually use it for VFR flying. It's awesome. They have all the sectional charts. They show like where restricted airspace is, where your class C airspace is, so that way you know if you have to be in contact with air traffic control. Here's another. Well, that's a class C right there too. Yep. So it just shows you all the airspaces and minimum altitudes that you should have. And again, this could be used for real world aviation, but with that plugin, it just takes the data from your flight simulator and puts it in there and acts like your flight simulator's the GPS. So there's no need to use the old GPS on this if you have this. And just to show off a little bit, I got my old monitor from back in the day, back to my father. He's using it for a security system, and I have a plugin for Google Earth, which tracks my aircraft over Google Earth, so it actually shows like the terrain. I'll actually go over this thing in another video. It's really cool. You can use it again for Flight Simulator X or Flight Simulator 2004. But with the Avare app, it's just awesome. I showed you basically what it does. Configuring is a little hard, especially on Flight Simulator 2004, not so much on Flight Simulator X. So why don't we get into that next? So once again, the apps that you want to download, sorry about the focusing, is Avare, and then this thing called the Avare External Input Output, I/O. Again, that's the plugin to make it work with the Flight Simulator. If you're using it in the real world, you just need that app. You don't just use the GPS in your tablet or phone, whatever you're using. So download those two apps to the Google Play Store. After you download the apps, what you're going to need for Flight Simulator 2004, again, you're going to start with Flight Simulator 2004, so you're going to need this app from Peter Downs' insight. You might know him as the guy that made FSUIPC. Again, I'll leave a link in the description here, but you're going to need this GPSOut 2.61 or whatever version he has. This is right now in 2017. That's what the newest one is. Last updated May 8th, 2013. So, don't worry about FSX. We're not going to worry about that. But you are going to need this for Flight Simulator 2004. You're going to need to install that in your Flight Simulator Modules folder. So, and it should install a GPSOut.dll and this GPSOut.ini. Make sure those are installed. And then what we're going to do is we're going to edit this GPSOut.ini. Again, read the directions here to make sure that you install that in the right place, which is the modules folder of your Flight Simulator 9 or Flight Simulator 2004 install. All right, here's where things get a little hairy for Flight Simulator 2004. Once you install this module, you're going to double click on this GPSOut.ini. And this is going to have this whole notepad file that you need to edit. Okay, now I'm going to show you what works on my computer. First off, this is the biggest thing. There are parameters for different GPS programs, okay? So like, you know, Flight Map, which is the all-powerful iPad app for flying. Avare is probably the best one I found for Android, other than the Garmin, which actually costs money. But Avare is free, so like that's why I use it. There are different protocols or parameters that are sent to different ones, okay? The only one that I use are the RMC, which is the best for Flight Map, provides course and ground speed, but no altitude. And because of that, I put RMC there to make that applicable because it works with Avare, okay? But it has no altitude, so therefore I go to GGA, which I also add with a comma and a space. GGA also works with Flight Map and others, provides altitude. So there's your altitude, but not course and speed. But again, remember, the RMC protocol provides the course and ground speed, and the GGA provides the altitude. And when you use both together by saying what sentences you want to use in the GPS out module, it will give all that stuff to Avare. I hope that made sense. You want those two protocols to send out that data to the Avare app. I ran the problems. If you add protocols that you don't need, it might make the Avare app not work. The plugin just stop. Also, you will need Bluetooth, by the way, which we will get to in a second. Bluetooth works best. There are other ways of doing it, but I find that Bluetooth is the way to work. So you'll need Bluetooth on your tablet. Okay, scrolling down, there's a bunch of stuff about this, just other things you want to do. Over here, this, where is it? All right, let's go interval. Interval specifies the interval in milliseconds at which the GPS set data is sent, okay? So the number's 100, bear in mind that the serial port, which is through Bluetooth, is about 65 characters per interval. So, default port speed of 9600, blah, 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 blah. Honestly, I just keep the 1500, just like the Peter Downson says to do. That's what he does, so I just leave it at 1500, works fine for me. The port, you will have to go into your Bluetooth settings and find out what COM port, serial ports through Bluetooth you have. Mine is set to COM5, okay? There is wide FS. I don't use that at all. I don't need that. You do need FS UIPC. You should get that anyways because it's needed for like half the programs for Flight Simulator 2004 if you use it like Squawk Box, other ones to connect to VATSIM. So, but I use COM5. I'll show you where to get that information next, actually. I'll try to show it to you. You have to go into your Bluetooth settings on your laptop. So once again, I got the three monitor set up, so I'm gonna go, this is Windows 10. I'm gonna go all the way to the edge here, and I'm gonna click the little arrow. You might see that at the lower right corner of your monitor. And then I actually bought a separate Bluetooth USB thing, and only because the one in my laptop, it's not working. I tried hooking up like a Bluetooth speaker to it and stuff, and I just went and bought a cheap one off eBay. Has the newest standard for Bluetooth, which I believe is 4.2, something like that. But anyways, it came with its own little software program. Sorry about the focus. You right click that and you show Bluetooth settings, okay? When you do Bluetooth settings, it's got this thing called COM ports, and it shows you COM ports that are installed, okay? Just select one of these. One of these has to work. That's why I put COM5, okay? And it's incoming. It doesn't matter. Just try these different ports under your port thing here in the GPSOut.ini file, a NIT file, if you will, and one of these should work for the program. So that's why you put one of those comms in the ports there. All right, moving on. Next thing is speed. This is almost like if you remember modems from back in the day. I know that some of you might not remember modems or even used one, but this is the speed at which the data is sent to the moving map program, which is Avare in this case. Okay, most GPS's output at 4800 or 96. I leave it at 96. Recent versions of Flight Map, again, that's a paid software program. That's probably the most popular program out there, honestly, but it's only for iPad. Support 19,200 or higher. I leave it just 9600. Says use the highest speed you can. I'm I could change this in the future, but this is what works for me. That's what's working when I showed you that. Okay. And then this POS to 6 decimal, I just leave it as yes, because it's going to send out the data as 6 fractional decimal places instead of 4. It makes it more accurate, I guess. Okay, and then this thing at the bottom, sim mode indicator, I don't even know what that is. I just leave it as no at default. And that's how you set up this GPSOut.ini. Problems you might run into, it's all about this first, the protocols that you're going to use to send data. I tried using 4 of these. Honestly, what happened was I'd connected to my Bluetooth, and then after about 2 minutes, it would just disconnect from the Bluetooth, and it would say no GPS data, okay? So you only want to use the ones that you need, and for me, what worked was the RMC and the GGA. Don't use anything else, because it'll give you everything you need for Avare to work, okay? All right, now we have to look at our app. And what we're going to look at first is how to actually get everything hooked up on your tablet. So we're going to go to the tablet next. Okay, we're back on the tablet. And if you notice, I put shortcuts right on the tablet and home screen to Avare and the Avare external input-output app. I will try to leave links to that Google Play Store for these two apps in the description. But what you want to do first, to get this started, after you've already configured your GPSOut.ini, okay? I'm gonna start with Avare first. All right, so I hit menu, and it pops up all these things. You're gonna go to preferences, okay? And you're gonna go to GPS. Now, if you were gonna use this in an airplane, like with just the GPS in the actual tablet, like you're using it in real life flight, you would have to select a different GPS position source, okay? This short GPS update period, we want that because that'll update it faster. And we do want to warn it if the GPS comes disabled, because that way you know there's something wrong with the connection between Flight Simulator and this. Or if you're roll flying, something wrong with your GPS. You don't want to keep flying thinking, oh, everything's hunky-dory, the GPS isn't connected. But the main thing that we're concerned about is GPS position source, okay? I'm going to click on that. It's going to pop up this submenu. It says all available, internal only, which means the internal GPS on the tablet or device that you're running this on, or the Avare input-output module only. Now, I only use this with Flight Sim. Again, I'm doing my private pilot license. Everything's visual. There's no distraction needed because we're supposed to fly with our eyes out of the cockpit. But when I do Flight Simming, just to have some fun into where I am and see the sectional chart and, you know, practice my sectional chart reading, I'm going to select Avare input-output module only, okay? If you want to use the GPS, you can select internal only or all available. Now, again, we'll use the GPS inside the tablet. But seeing that we're using this for flight simming right now, whether it's FSX or FS2004, you need to set it to the same thing, okay? All right, so we select that, and I'm going to back out twice, and if you notice, it's showing the last thing that I flew on. So I exited, but that's the last thing I flew on. What it might do too is it might just show you where you are right now with your actual GPS, but you'll see that says no GPS signal. So we know it's not connected to the flight simulator nor the input-output module. But again, we haven't even started that yet. If you start Avare, you make sure that thing is selected in the menu. Once you select it once, by the way, it will always be that till you change it. And then we're going to hit the home button to get to the home screen. And we're going to start the Avare external input output. Now, at this point, you already have Flight Simulator 2004 or X working, okay? All right. And what you need to do is you need to select this for Bluetooth, okay? There's many different ways of hooking up to it. And notice that says Microsoft Flight Simulator. However, this is for 2004 only. We're going to start with that, okay? And we're going to select Bluetooth because this does not work with Flight Simulator 2004. And we'll get to Flight Simulator X a little bit later, okay? So we're going to select Bluetooth, right? You got to make sure your Bluetooth is on and functional, okay? It doesn't have to be hooked up to anything. Notice that mine's not connected to anything, okay? I'm going to go back to the Avare input-output. So once we have it set for Bluetooth, we'll make sure our Bluetooth's on. I'm going to go here, and you're going to select your computer, okay? This is my laptop, new laptop. This is Bluetooth headphones that I use to watch movies at night. So you have to select the right Bluetooth device. This tablet's already paired up with my laptop. That's why it shows up. So make sure you pair your Bluetooth with whatever your computer or laptop is. That's why you need the Bluetooth adapter. So I'm going to select new laptop. Okay. And then I'm just going to push connect. And you'll notice that starts sending data out. Okay. Now, for Flight Simulator 2004, this is where it gets buggy, because if you did something wrong, it's going to stop sending data after a while. But right now, that's what's being sent to the Avare app. So I'm going to go home. We have to leave this running. So hit home. Go back to the Avare app. Again, it just updated to where I am in the Flight Simulator. I'm in Albany. I'm at Albany International. And it updated where I am. And it's showing vertical speed, track, ground speed, and nothing. And that's because I'm parked at Albany. Okay? So that's why this will work. And then once I start flying, it's going to start moving on the sectional. Okay? It's just going to track me. And this is what I would be doing in real life with the GPS. It's just that now your GPS is your flight simulator, thanks to the external input-output module. You can use this as your GPS. It will show you if you enter in your destination or your flight plan. It will show you bearings and stuff like that. Again, realistic, more realistic than the one in the actual flight simulator, because this could be used in the real world. All right, anyways, let me get up in the air and I'll show you it working. So as you can probably see it here, we are moving. Hands off the yoke here, so hopefully it just stays level. I did trim it out though. And the Avare app, which is still connected, is showing where I'm going. I'm tracking 131. I am climbing at 600 feet per minute. My ground speed is 84 knots, and I'm about 2,742 feet in the air. And I'll update over time, okay? All right, now, again, this will just keep tracking. So that's outside Albany. Okay, shows where I am in the sectional. But it doesn't show any bearings or anything because I have to enter in my waypoints, okay? I'm just going to say basically find. I'm going to go direct to Plymouth. So I go find, which is down here. Okay, if you had a plan, it would show you where the plan is. I'm going to say Plymouth, which is where I fly out of in real life. And if you notice, it gives me a bearing, it gives me the estimated time, it gives me the distance, and it tells me where I'm going. That's my next waypoint, okay? All right, so what I would do is I'd fly at 122. And it has the purple line to show me where I should be going. So it looks just like a GPS at this point, except it shows the sectional, and it lets you fly. And that's why this app is just cool, okay? So that was Flight Simulator 2004. That's how to do it in Flight Simulator 2004. It can be a little buggy with this, by the way. Sometimes if you exit out of the the input-output, sometimes if you exit out of the Avare input-output, it will do some weird, funky things, and it will drop the GPS to Avare. If you leave it on like this, you should be fine. You can minimize by using the home button. Don't exit out. And it will work fine. I have used it on longer flights, like an hour, 2 hours. With FSX, it's a lot more stable. But this is how you get it working in Flight Simulator 2004. Next, we'll show you how to use this with FSX. All right, part two to this. And I will do this the best I can. How to use the Avare app with FSX. Okay, first thing, like Flight Simulator 2004, you will need a program like GPSOut. However, you're not going to use GPSOut on Flight Sim X. You're going to use this program called XConn, okay? And it's by Ubi Sumis. Sorry if I pronounced that wrong, but this is the program that you want to get. I'll leave a link in the description again. He tells you exactly what it does, which is the same thing as GPSOut, just for Flight Sim X, okay? So, what is XConn? FSX doesn't provide GPS output. That's why you can't use Avare, just FSX. Well, this connects FSX and generates missing GPS data from FSX's aircraft present position. You can hook it up to Avare and other apps, basically. Okay? So, he said it was designed to get familiar with Pocket FMS, which is on this website, which is also where you download it from. And I've got that down over here. If you go to this website, okay, Pocket FMS down utility, and it's right here, XConn. You want to download that, okay? And then you just install it. So we download XConn by clicking on it. And then you just follow the directions in this manual here. L2,
file to where it goes. It says copy the contents of the zip file to a folder of your choice. Start FSX in windowed mode. So I'm going to start FSX. That might take a little bit on my computer. And start XConn as soon as that's loaded. So we're going to let FSX boot up, then we'll start XConn. This is FSX Steam Edition. Way better than the disk version, in my honest opinion, because it has all these fixes. I still edit the config file for myself to do all these things. But anyways, what I have here, I have XConn, that program I just told you about. It's on the desktop in a folder called XConn. I just leave it there. So it can be anywhere on your computer. You just double-click to start it, all right? And then, if you go to your lower right in Windows 10, you should have this arrow again where your Bluetooth settings are. You're going to go to XConn. And if you notice, I already have FSX working, so it's already connected. But if we right-click and we go to Properties, it's going to have things to configure, okay? This is all in the manual that comes with XConn. All right, so FSX, the flight is running. I'm going to go back to XConn for a second, my way. And again, you just click on that little arrow, right-click on XConn, go to Properties, okay? It's going to pop up the settings box again. Output, again, your IP address that you need, and the port. The port's going to be important because you have to put that into the external input-output app on your tablet. Okay, this NMEA, it's just like FS2004, what I showed you there. If you didn't see it, these are the protocols that are sent to Avare or any other thing. So I just leave them all checked. I never had any problems with them, okay? So I just leave them all checked. In 2004, again, if you watch that portion of the video, it was a little different, but FS2004 doesn't have XConn, which is, I think, a better program for that, but that's the best you're going to do in 2004. Time, I don't really mind whatever. I use universal time from FSX. And the satellites is basically how many satellites. I don't think that really matters, seeing that you're using a flight simulator. But anyways, the important thing you want to do before you leave is remember this port number, 49002, or whatever port you set it to. Okay, just push OK. So we have Flight Simulator X loaded. Flight, we're at Providence right now. Okay, what we're going to do is we're going to go back to the XConn app here, or software if you will. Again, click the right arrow near your bot, right click, select Properties. Okay, I went through all this stuff already. So to configure this with your tablet, you're going to stay on the output thing, okay? Now, I entered in the IP address that they have there in the actual manual to next door to that. Sorry, I'll show you. But what you need to do, okay, to use this with your thing, is you have to start the Avare app, okay? We're going to push OK. We're just going to make it go in the background behind the menu. So it's still on, just in the background. Then we're going to go to our Avare external input-output app, okay? And first thing that you want to do, you want to make sure that the port number, which is 49002 there, you want to make sure that's the same port number on your input-output app, okay? And if you notice, it says connect to Microsoft Flight Simulator. This was set to Bluetooth for FS2004. Okay, we're not using Bluetooth anymore. We're using the actual Microsoft Flight Simulator part here. Okay, and that's what this looks like. That's why it looks different than FS2004 if you looked at that portion of the video. And it gives you the number that it's looking for, 192.168.1.16. So that's the IP address that I need to put into my XConn app. So 192.168, and this is connected to my router, but this connects right to my tablet. So that's going to listen to it on that IP address with that port. I'm just going to push OK. And we go back to our app, which told us where to connect to. It says the right port number. We're going to push listen. And if you notice, it starts loading the data. And that will send that data to your Avare app. They notice that this was a lot easier for Flight Simulator 2004. Okay. So we push the menu because we want to leave that in the background. And then we're going to go back to the Avare app. And if you notice, it has everything you need, and it even shows us at Providence. Again, it's the same thing as 2004, just for FSX. And it will follow you, and it will do all the things that I showed during the FS2004 part of this. It'll just follow your plane.
Again, awesome app for Flight Simulator X or Flight Simulator 2004. And the best part is it's all free. One last thing I want to show you, though, is that you do have to download all these sectionals, okay? So the sectional charts. You're going to go to Menu. You're going to go to Download. And this takes quite a lot of time, but you could download all these things, whether TFRs, temporary flight restrictions. The big thing for us, if you're doing general aviation, is the VFR sectional charts. And they update them too, so they've got all of them. And if you notice, I downloaded all of them, there's some in the Caribbean even. Okay, you can only download just the ones you need. If I was doing where I live in New England, it's the New York sectional. Okay, it even has the date, so this is a little outdated. It says February to March, okay? So I can actually update that by clicking Update. It's going to update all the sectionals. But again, that takes quite a while. But once you have them in there, they have everything you need. They have IFR, low and high, so if you're flying jets, you can use this. I mean, area plates, airport facility directory images, which I don't know what that is, but there's a bunch of things. Actually, I do know what it is. It's the actual airport maps, so I downloaded those. Terrain has all these things that you can download and put into the Avare app, and again, it's free, but they do ask you to not update every day, only download one the ones you need, because the bandwidth they use, they want to not use it up and make a slowdown for other people. So you can download all of them, though. They will let you download all of them. And again, it's just, it's a great app to have, okay? Especially if you're getting used to doing sectionals. So, that is my review of the Avare app and how to use it with Flight Simulator 2004 and Flight Simulator X. Hey, YouTubers, just to remind you, we'd love it if you subscribe to Eric Flight below. And also, check out my Patreon page if you'd like to support me directly. Anything would help to basically further our adventure in flight and flight simulation. And I appreciate just watching my videos. So thank you very much, and I'll see you in the future.